Welcome to the PIX, this is Shadex. This is the third episode of a series dedicated to the shaders in Godot engine. In this first episode, I will teach you how to make this simple flag effect in Visual Shaders. So this is our finished project, finished flag. And I will now make it from scratch. So let's put this reference flag somewhere here, so it will not distract us. And now I will make a new one. First of all, we need a mesh instance and a cylinder for the pole. So the flag will be not in the air, but will be connected with this pole. We need to put this a little bit higher, okay. Of course, this pole is way too big. So, top radius 0.1, bottom 0.1, height maybe 3 segments. Well, for this pole, minimum and rings. Also, we need using beacon lights, much better. And we have our pole, but now let's make it flag, new flag. And we need a material. I have some sample material here, metal parts. It's okay. So we have a pole. Now the actual flag. So we need another mesh instance, but now need to be a plane mesh. And as we see, it's not properly rotated, so let's rotate it like this. This will be 19, 0. For our view, let's make it 19 also. A little bit to the top. And to the right. Let's zoom in on this view. Okay. This and this. Yes. So now it's connected, it's our flag, but it doesn't move and it doesn't have the texture. So this is where the visual shaders is very helpful, because it's easy to make and will give us this nice flag effect in like no time. Let's make it a little bit closer. Okay. And this is our logo. Now we make a new shader material and of course visual shader. When we click on this, we could open the editor and just change to camera one view, so we will see this top view and our shader bottom. So first we have fragment and vector shaders. Fragment shader is basically for each pixel in this texture, you calculate the color. And vertex shader is for each vertex, we will calculate the position. So, first fragment. Fragment shader is very easy. We need an input. And the input is UV. So this is the position of each of these pixels on the flag. Next, we need a texture. And of course, texture or this texture. This is texture uniform, not this one, this texture. Here we can load material flag, I have this, the normal PNG file, as you can see, and we need to connect the UV. This is how it looks like, and connect this to albedo. Albedo is the color of the material, and I rotated this wrongly. Okay, now it's rotated as it should, and when we are here, let's edit our mesh. We need a subdivide, so we have more vertexes right now, because right now we have only one vertex for the whole material. Let's make like 12 here and 12 here. I can cheat and look. Okay, I use 16 and 2, so let's make also 16 on the width, so we will have 16 vertexes to morph this, and only 2 from the top to the bottom, as we only move this flag in one direction. It's a simple flag. So back to the material and open editor. Okay, so we have our fragment shader. This is just a simple material. We don't need any metallic roughness and so on, but if you want to have something like more like a fabric, then this is the perfect place to make this. But for now, let's stay like it is. Now the vertex shader. This is a little bit more complicated. And first of all, we need also an input. But this time, vertex. So this is for the each vertex, the position of those vertexes. And we will normally, we just connect this vertex to this vertex. So for each input, we go to the output. Now we will modify this in between to make the magic happen. First, we need X, Y, and Z. So we use vector decompose and also vertex compose. And now we put this here, this here. So we take the input, and for each X, Y, and Z. Okay, right now we just move this so we have more space. Okay, but we want to modify basically the Y position, so it will move. So let's take a Y position from here. And let's make, first of all, to move it, we need a time. So let's make an input, and the time. Okay, I will explain this in a moment, but first we need to have few boxes here. But this time will be too fast, so we also need a scalar operation. Oh yes, scalar operation, and we will multiply this by 3, and then another scalar operation, let's add this to our Y position. Our flag flies away. Now we have Y let's make it x position. So now it makes more sense. For each x position, we take the x position, we take the time, multiply by 3 to make it bigger, to make it bigger impact, and then scalar function. We need a sinus. Sinus will move our flag from one side to other side. So from minus 1 to plus 1, we input our time to the sinus position. So now, and put this here, as you can see, it moves. So why we use this x? Without this x, if we just add it like that, it will move with the sinus. Every vertex will move the same. But with that, that's scalar operations. When we add x to this, so now the sinus is shifted by each x direction. That's why we have this nice wave. We shift the sinus. Okay, so it's, we're getting there, but our flag should not move. Let's use another view and view this view. It will be perfectly seen that whole flag moves like this, big wave. But as we know, normal flags don't move like this. This is our reference flag. It stays perfectly still in the beginning and starts to move more and more and more to the end. And it moves as our flag just on the end. So what will be perfect for this? A gradient. So let's add a gradient here. We need, first of all, an input with UV. Move it down. Then we need a texture, another texture. And I have already made the gradient, but if you need a gradient, you click here, make a gradient texture, make it a new gradient, and this is exactly what we need. From the dark to the white. And dark means no movement, white means maximum of the movement. And we save this as the gradient. I've already done this, so I will not save this as new one. Open the editor. I will use exactly the same file, materials, flag, and this is the gradient. UV is needed, so we can take each pixel of this gradient, but we only need a one dimension of it. So we need to decompose vector. So we take this RGB. Well, here is RGB, here is X, Y, Z, but that's all just numbers. So for our RGB, we just take the X. And now we can scalar operation. Take scalar operation, and we need scalar intercept. Oh, this is one I did it. We mix this, so remove this, and we mix our sinusoid and our X. Sorry. Here, our original Y. But using the gradient. It's reversed. So let's just, the easy way is to move sinus down and original value at the top. And we already have this funky wave. But it's moving too fast. When we change this one to original, we only changing the speed because time. So we want this as a free, so it need to move fast, but not that much. To make this, we use this scalar operation and we multiply our sinus by some lower value, like 0.2. Let's make a little bit of cleanup here. Move all of those to the right. Scalar operation. And our gradient here. And now it moves a little bit better. And we need one more thing, another scalar operation, because now we calculate this shift here. Can we just copy and paste? There were some duplication. Oh yes, Ctrl D, duplicate will do the job. So once more, remove this and connect this our shift with original Y, and still use this original Y here. Now it moves a little bit better. Okay. But it still moves like more like a snake, not like a flag. So to make it more interested, I also Ctrl D multiply our gradient. Remove this. And once more, we need some space. Our gradient by, like, let's say 3. Now, this gradient is more saturated, like say. So it moves more to the right, and 0 is always 0, so that's why it's static in the beginning and move in the end. As we can see, this is the movement of our flag, this is our flag, and it already looks kinda nice. So just by those few clicks, we have a working flag. It's not that scary when you know what each of those boxes do. There's a lot of those boxes, and I just learn them one by one, try to add them, and most of the time it's just as multiplication, addition, subtraction, sinusoid, and some texture. Thanks, and I hope that you learn something new. See you in another episode.